You are watching America Trends. I'm Mary Burt-Godwin, and I'm gonna go out and get me some of those free skates, at least for my kids. Maybe I'll try them, I'm not sure. But speaking of entrepreneurs, which Jeff and John were, we have a wonderful guest here today. Her name is Dr. Silvia Ma, and she is an entrepreneur herself, an investor, and now you help other women start their own businesses and help them blossom into entrepreneurs.
Exactly.
I'm so happy to have you here, Silvia.
I'm so blessed to be here. Thank you for having me.
Now tell us, you know, when I was talking to you, you said, oh, I started an accelerator, Stella Labs, mm-hmm. right? So tell the audience first what an accelerator is.
Yeah, so an accelerator, a lot of people have a definition problem or challenge mm-hmm. between accelerator, incubator, and co-working spaces.
Okay.
And they all do amazing things for entrepreneurs to give them resources, space, mentorship, education. An accelerator is a program that is faster, like accelerating something.
Yeah.
We just talked about skates, right? You're accelerating yourself through space or through your entrepreneurship journey.
Yeah.
An incubator necessarily is one that is more and like you incubate there. You're there for 3, 6, 10, 12 months, maybe 24 months. And there means either a physical space.
I was gonna say, it's actually a place that you go
sometimes.
To.
Okay. I mean, like right now with COVID, right? Yeah. We are a lot more virtual.
Yeah.
So spaces mean maybe a hybrid space. You have a little bit of a physical space. You have a little bit of a virtual space. And then co-working before pandemic was really, you're gonna come in, you're gonna be a member month to month to month. And they have programs for entrepreneurs to grow, but you're kind of growing as you're going through that co-working
space. You're on your own.
Yeah, you're on your own.
Yeah, but an accelerator.
You come into the program, you're accelerating through a program or an educational experience, or we call them intensives, or you come in and work with us for our Women's Fast Pitch, which is a pitch competition, and then you come out of the program, and we still support you. We believe at Stella Labs that alumni are alumni for life, uh-huh. so we always are constantly connecting with our alumni, making sure that they're supported in their entrepreneurial journeys.
And do you also help them find investors and
yes.
that part of their journey? Because I think as a startup or anyone that's, you know, has a great idea, they have a nugget of an idea, but they're thinking, I don't know how to even fund this.
Yes.
Right? That's what you help.
Yes.
Do.
And the two pieces are access to capital that you just talked about, access to investors, access to different types of funding, because there are different types of funding, and access to education and resources. So an accelerator that we do, Stella Labs, we also give that resources we just talked about. But that access to capital is super, super important, because the entrepreneurs that are out there don't have that access to an investor or an investor group. And we also have Stella Angels, which is our angel group, which is okay. a female angel group that female angels get together and they invest in female entrepreneurs. And that is our investment thesis.
Wow, that's awesome. Now, tell me a little bit about yourself, because I know that you yourself are an entrepreneur.
Yep.
You started a couple companies.
Yeah.
And tell us about your journey.
Wow, a journey. Do you have like a couple hours? No, I'm just kidding.
We've got 4 minutes. Okay,
good. That's good. Now, oh my goodness. Oh, where do I start? No, so I'm a scientist by training. I have my PhD in biochemistry.
Okay.
What am I doing now as an entrepreneur? But love the scientific process, curiosity, determination to get your PhD too helps in the entrepreneurial journey.
Yeah.
And then fast forward, I am an entrepreneur. I do have a podcast and I have a book that's coming out. And that's my entrepreneurial journey, and also creating Stella Labs. So even if Stella Labs is a not-for-profit, it is a business, right?
Right.
So that is that entrepreneurial pursuit that I had.
Yeah.
And just love what I do. I love supporting entrepreneurs in their journey, launching, scaling, giving them access to capital. And then about 2 years ago, we created Ad Astra Ventures, which is a sister venture group for Stella Labs that allows us as investors, it's just two other partners and myself, we invest in the most promising female-led businesses.
Wow. Okay, so if there's a female out there watching
yes.
who's thinking, okay, I've got an idea and I need a little capital,
yeah.
how does a woman get connected with you, no matter, somebody from any part of the country?
Yes, and thank you for bringing that up. Stella Labs is now virtual because of the pandemic. We mm-hmm. have so many different kinds of programs. So we have our Women's Fast Pitch that happens every Tuesday between July and August. And it is a pitch competition across the United States in 7 regions
wow,
of the United
cool.
States. So if you do have an idea, your idea, first of all, is worth it. Secondly, you have the confidence and the determination to actually launch it.
Yeah.
Like, don't think you don't, right?
Yeah.
Because us women, we're like analysis paralysis.
Yeah,
we're thinking
fear.
About fear.
Fear takes over, huge. Sure.
Imposter syndrome. No, that's a way. And we have a group, of a village, a team, a tribe, whatever you want to call it, that will support you in the launch of your businesses and also that scale of that idea to be able to pitch in front of an investor. So you go on our website, sign up for the Women's Fast Pitch if you do have a company, and we will support you all along the journey.
So is it like the Fast Pitch, is it like a Shark Tank type
yes.
of thing?
Okay. Yes, we have actually, the judges that we have are either our Stella Angels, our Stella Angel groups that actually write checks to female entrepreneurs.
We like those people.
I know. Write a check, people. If you are an investor out there and do have capital, I always say write that check.
Yeah, and help the next person.
Help the next person. Yeah. And even like, what does an investment look like? Sometimes it's as little as $2,000 all the way up to $25,000, $50,000, $100,000. So I want, you know, sometimes we do a lot of education around what does it mean to be an investor. And we really want female entrepreneurs and female investors to know that it is a possible, right, to make that connection. So you were asking about the Shark Tank. We have judges who are either Stella Angels or are angel syndicates.
Okay.
So syndicate means that you invest with another person, right? So you syndicate a deal, you share a deal, and then those investors say, okay, I want to come alongside you to invest in this one entrepreneur. So we have real judges that are real investors like Shark Tank, and you get to win your region, and then you go on to the Women's Venture Summit, which is in September, mid-September, and that's when you pitch in front of 500 people to receive a $10,000 investment.
Wow, that is so cool. And women all over the country can do this.
Women all over the country. And it's been really cool. The central part of the United States, last year we did our first like nationwide, huge pitch. And we did it was in the middle of the pandemic. So a little bit challenging, but we really wanted to be with the entrepreneur. We want to come alongside you. We want to sit beside you. We want to support you as Stella Labs. So the central part of the United States are like, wow, we've never been able to pitch to a group of just women.
Yeah.
Like that was, and we were like, wow, great. And other regions also said, wow, we've never had that opportunity to just it be all women investors listening to us. How powerful is that, right?
Yeah.
And that's what we really build those bridges and make those opportunities happen for the entrepreneurs.
This is so cool. Now tell me about any success stories. You know, what are some of the types of businesses that you're seeing come through?
Yeah, great question. So the types of businesses that come through range in all industries, from medical devices, all the way to pharma, all the way to consumer product goods, to nutrition products, femtech, legal tech.
What's femtech?
Let me talk about that.
I don't know that term. What is
that? Yes, femtech is any technology that allows for females to have a better life, right? So it could be a platform that allows women to congregate and learn more about menopause. Right.
Okay.
Or femtech could be we invested in a cervical fluid device that measures cervical fluid. And that's a medical device. And that is femtech as well.
OK,
so it could be anything, a platform, a physical product, a pharma that incorporates the woman's health or the woman's lifestyle, let's say.
OK,
so something
about helping a working mom
exactly.
juggle it all.
Yes.
Who's got that? Please, I will invest.
And
whatever
too.
That product is.
And me too. So really all industries we really support in the Women's Fast Pitch, right? Because we, as investors, we are looking for a product or a SaaS platform or let's say artificial intelligence platform, some kind of technology that allows us to invest in it that really has that return that we're looking for.
That's so incredible. And where do you find your investors?
Oh, great question. I love that. So we really focus in on the aspiring angel investor, which is probably the hardest person to find. And those an investor needs to be an accredited angel investor. Doesn't mean that you have to have a certificate or anything like that. You just have to have a certain amount of wealth. There's about 4 to 7 types of different ways that you can be an accredited angel investor. And it's basically a self-assignment.
Okay.
Right? And with that, you can really go after any woman that has wealth in the nation. Right? And I think in the next 2 or 3 years, over 50% of the wealth will be dominated by women, right? So, right? So we love that. But how do you entice them? How do you equip them and educate them to say, oh, I want to invest? Because angel investing is the most, risky investment. So if you're looking at your whole portfolio of investments from real estate to stock market to any kind of investor, and then angel investment or VC, it's very high risk.
Right.
So the more that you get educated, the more that you have a community that helps you invest, a community that helps you with sourcing, like the Women's Fast Pitch, you get to really deep.
Probably the most payoff too, biggest payoff, I would
say. Yes, so. It's one in nine survives, so why not invest?
Well, Silvia, I'm so happy you were here with us today. And where can we find you? Stillalabs.org.
Yes,
is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, I hope that women out there got some inspiration. Stillalabs.org. And stick around, we've got comedian Rusty Nails after the break. You are watching America Trends with Mary Burt-Godwin.